we got? Where's it at?
Role-playing exercises, recreating the fog of war at Joint Base McGuire-Dix Lakehurst, caps off more than a year of extensive training for the Delaware Army National Guard's 153rd Military Police Company.
All right, let's go. We got someone down over here.
Soldier mentors and civilians play the part of Afghan Uniform Police, or AUP, as Delaware MPs respond to an explosion that's left an Afghan policeman injured.
We have a left leg amputation. Multiple lacerations to the chest.
Meanwhile, other soldiers on foot make their way through one of three simulated Afghan villages on post.
It looks like the lieutenant has gone missing.
As they search for a missing AUP lieutenant. All while trying to communicate with their Afghan counterparts through an interpreter.
And then the half that stays here with us.
The benefit of creating these stressful environment is, you know, not every day is going to be stressful. Not every day is going to be blowing stuff up. But when it does happen, they've been through it, and it's something that's in the back of their mind. And it basically eases the process when it truly does happen.
In Afghanistan, the 153rd will teach Afghan police how to set up roadside checkpoints, secure building projects, and conduct walking patrols. A dangerous mission, taking into account insider attacks, have jumped sharply since 2008. According to the Department of Defense, between May 2007 and September 2012, there were 79 so-called green-on-blue attacks, causing 116 coalition deaths and 164 injuries. In 2012 alone, 37 insider attacks occurred, killing 51, including 32 Americans, and wounding 74. Sobering statistics, which is why, in addition to field exercises, the MPs have spent hours in the classroom receiving cultural and interpersonal training. The soldiers tell us many insider threats stem from a cultural disagreement.
You treat people like people. I mean, you hear the golden rule 1,000 times throughout our lives, you know, and so we take that approach with the mindset to the green on blue.
Treat people as you want to be treated, and that seems to be the information that we're getting will negate most of those incidences. So what we're doing is just to make sure that the common sense, compassionate, but at the same time always remain vigilant, always remain ready.
And that means really paying attention to the little things.
It could be anything ranging from you may have a Afghan police officer that you deal with quite frequently, and just you walk in today and he's quiet, he's not his normal self, maybe he stays distant. Subtle signs like that where most people may not key in on or think much of.
I think it would be, you know, foolish to say that it does not make you, you know, slightly nervous.
Christina Spaulding's daughter drives Humvees for the company.
The forces that they're training, there's no way to properly 100% vet them and make sure that their intentions are, you know, honorable, that they're there to do the right thing. They've trained very hard and very, very well for the missions.
Obviously, we're trained to deal with that and try and mitigate it. We have training, you know, to avoid this from happening. But honestly, it's all about making that good first connection.
I don't try to dwell on it and think about it too much. And just, I told her just to be careful, you know, stay close with the guys that she's with and just keep her head up all the time.
Members of the 153rd said their goodbyes to family members in January.
This is not the day we look forward to. The day we look forward to is a day that all of you come home safely.
This is Sergeant Jake Lindell's second combat tour. But wife Denise says it never gets easier.
This time, I really know the heartache that's going to be involved in him leaving, and just to see the children go through it, it's very, very difficult.
For Denise and daughters Ava and Taylor, this time next year can't come soon enough.
They're all trained very well. I have no doubt in my mind that they'll all come home safely, and they're going to go over there and do the job that they need to do and get back to their families.